Class of 2024, welcome to Roar Pride Week. My name is Pam Roecker, Dean of Athletics, and you're at today's Meet the Administration. We've met many of you on your visits and at open houses, and we know you have good familiarity with our program from your head coach, but we're excited to introduce ourselves, give you an idea of our roles at Regis, and a little bit about our playing careers. Yes, hard to believe we were actually athletes too at one time and have made this our life's work. So I grew up in Madison, Wisconsin, and had a playing career in basketball at the University of Wisconsin, Green Bay. Actually went on to coach 15 years of Division I women's basketball and have had a almost 35-year career in this amazing profession. So I'm gonna turn it over to Ron LeClair. What's your story? What's your background, Ron?
Thanks, Pam. I'm Ron LeClair. I'm the Assistant Athletic Director and Head Athletic Trainer here at Regis College. I was a three-sport varsity athlete in high school, but chose to go to a Division I college, and that ended my playing career. But as an athletic trainer, I've been at every level possible, from the Super Bowl down to sixth grade high school athletics. And over the last 9 years, I've spent at the Division III level, and the last three here at Regis. So we're excited to have you guys on board. Can't wait to meet you.
Awesome.
Hi, everybody. My name is Mark Clementi. I'm the Associate Athletic Director. Currently, I manage the operations of the athletic program. I proudly hail myself from Rhode Island. Went to the college in North Carolina, where I was a four-year collegiate soccer player. And then early in the 2000s, I went into the coaching field where I served as an assistant coach at a rival institution in New England, and been fortunate enough to be at Regis since 2002, where I served as the women's soccer coach, also the sports information director, then had the chance to start our women's lacrosse program, and then later moved on to the administration in 2010. It's been a great run.
Awesome. Laura.
Hi, everyone. I think we may have already met this week, but again, my name is Laura Violet, Assistant Athletic Director and Senior Women Administrator. I am a Division III professional through and through. I am from Connecticut. I hail from Connecticut. I went to Eastern Connecticut State University, where I played 4 years of D3 soccer. Go East. Part of a very competitive program there, and was inspired to work in intercollegiate athletics. I actually came to Regis as a grad student, working in the Department of Athletics, got my master's, worked at Becker College for a few years, and then I was hired back at Regis in 2015 in this role, and I've been here ever since. I love Division III, and I'm really excited for you guys to get an awesome, well-rounded Division III experience at Regis.
Awesome. Thank you, everybody. And to our student athletes in the Zoom today with us, I hope you feel that enthusiasm and passion we all had for our sports and our professional careers. And one of the themes this week, and hopefully you've had through your whole recruitment process, is we are here to help you. We want this to be the greatest experience, the best 4 years of your life. We want you to achieve all your academic and athletic goals. And I think one of the things that's important, not only to learn about us and your head coaches and your teammates, but to learn a little bit about the legacy and the history of the program, because programs are not built overnight. And Mark, you're the veteran in the group. I think you're going into year 19, if I did my math correctly. Can you give us a little bit of an overview of kind of how far Regis has come?
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a tremendous 18 years for myself. And I'm really looking forward to the 19th. When I arrived, as I mentioned earlier, back in 2002, at an all-women's institution, believe it or not, we felt like we were competing outside on the soccer field that might have doubled as a cow pasture. We had the opportunity, really, over the years to really enjoy some tremendous growth. Obviously, a lot of changes took place. We had a tremendous investment in facilities in the athletic program to where now I think we've added 10 sports during my time there, in addition to the men. And, you know, now that we've made a couple conference changes, we've also been thrilled with the championship success. We've won over 40 championships over the years. And we're at a point now where our student athletes really have the facilities and everything they really need to be successful. No doubt that our facilities are probably the strongest that they step onto. We, unlike a lot of our Boston rivals, they're all right there on campus. So I think we really give the student athletes every tool they need to have a successful student athlete experience.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're really proud of those 20 sports, and I'm sure the facilities, as everybody in this class of 24 has toured Regis, has seen them, and we're really proud to have all of our teams right on campus, whether it's in the pool, tennis courts, softball field, track, gymnasium, turf. We are really blessed with having those facilities and that institutional support. We can't wait to see you on those facilities, by the way. And one of the things, though, if you're going to be on those facilities and you're going to be playing and competing, means you have to do the right thing in that classroom. And Laura Violet, I see you right there in front of College Hall, one of our best academic buildings, our big classroom buildings. And I'm going to turn it over to you to talk to the student athletes on the call a little bit about your role and the additional academic support your office is able to provide.
Thanks, Pam. So I'm in front of one of my favorite spots on campus, College Hall. Inside College Hall, I'm sure many of you have seen it, is a huge lobby area, foyer of College Hall. There are a ton of different spaces and places that you can spend time studying. And my role on campus is to make sure you have what you need to study and be successful academically. I'm really worried about making sure you're plugged into the support you need on campus. For me, it's important that you can identify who your advisor is, how to access tutoring or an academic coach on campus, and pretty much direct you to where the library and the Finucane O'Sullivan Learning Teagan Learning Commons are.
Well, you know, with this new remote learning, right, with this classes starting August 17th remotely, we'll talk a little bit later about some study tips along those lines too. So there's a little bit of a new normal. Certainly our students in the class of 24 have been transitioning with this learning model as they finish their high school careers, but there'll be some nuances. And Laura also works very closely with your coaches. And again, she'll talk more about that as this video continues. But speaking of the new normal, Ron LeClaire, I want to bring you in and your expertise in this field. I know we've all relied on it as we've kind of navigated this COVID-19 pandemic this summer. Talk to this freshman class that's so excited to get here. How can they kind of best position themselves to be ready to go and have a safe and healthy experience?
Yeah, that's a great question, Pam. And obviously the health, safety, and wellness of our student athletes is the utmost priority here at Regis. Nobody signs on to become a college athlete with the goal of being hurt and spending time with me and my staff in our room. So we understand that we need to do everything we possibly can to keep you active and in the pool and on the court and in on the field so that you can have that success and the great experience that you all want. At this time, it's very difficult with gyms not being open out there and people not having their normal preseason workout routines available to them. What we can do right now is screen ourselves, keep a daily tab of our temperature and our physical well-being, do some activity as long as we're healthy enough to do so, maintain social distancing, wear our masks when social distancing isn't possible. This is our new normal. This is what's going to be expected when you get onto campus, and this is the best way we can try to maintain your physical well-being and your health during this difficult time.
And I know, Ron, you're going to offer some tips a little bit later in our Zoom for success as well. But thank you for that kind of overview. And I think all of us are doing those same things in terms of our daily self-care inventory as we try to protect ourselves and certainly others. And one of the reasons we want people to come back healthy and happy and ready to go is, listen, let's be honest, we're all competitors at heart. You know, my eyes light up just thinking about my career, and you can see that with our administrative team as well. And we want you back competing. And one of the real proud moments for Regis is our affiliation with this conference called the Great Northeast Athletic Conference. I'm going to let Mark talk a little bit about it, but we're really excited to be a part of that league, and we really feel like it's a good fit. But Mark, can you take it away from there?
Yeah, thanks, Pam. Yeah, one of the things I mentioned earlier, I think that's really set us apart and helped our growth is that we've been able to, I think, fit in the perfect conference for ourselves right now, and that is the Great Northeast Athletic Conference. I have been involved in three conference transitions, and I can't be, I can't feel better about the place we're in right now at the Great Northeast Athletic Conference. Right now, we've got about 13 schools. We have 13 schools, and we're welcoming Dean College this year, to where I think we now have a good regional group of schools that we have some really healthy rivalries with, spread over six states. I think one of the best things, though, is that we really have the opportunity to compete in conference play against some local rivalries. It just makes sense. You know, right up the road, we've got LaSalle, and then we've got the Boston schools. But I think it's really produced a different energy for our student athletes, yes, being able to compete with schools like these. And, you know, nothing's better, as Pam mentioned, getting the field, getting Higgins Court jammed for a conference basketball or volleyball match.
Yeah.
You know, nothing beats having that kind of competition. Those of us at Regis know that, you know, we take a lot of pride in how we compete. We have respect for our opponents. And we also know that our respect for our opponents also means that, you know, we carry ourselves the Regis way. So we're also known as the loudest, the proudest, and the strongest supporters in the country.
I'll tell you what, the gym rocks when it's full, and when we can have some in-person pep rallies and have a chance to really fill that up again, the den, as you love to call it, I think these class of 24s will get a firsthand experience. And right on the GNAC logo, you know, it says sportsmanship, integrity, and community service. I want to hit a little bit of the sportsmanship piece, Mark, and then I'm going to kick it back to you on the community service. But one of the things we talk about around sportsmanship are just sort of how we handle ourselves on a daily basis. And I usually point to my I can point to it right now and talk about the respect and responsibility. We're seeing that in the movement today with the Black Lives Matter, treating each other with respect and dignity every day, whether it's our opponents, whether it's your teammates, whether it's your coaching staff. That's really important to us. We feel like it's a privilege to wear the uniform. It's a privilege that can be lost by, Laura Violet mentioned, not doing the right thing in the classroom, certainly by not doing the right thing in the community. But we want our student athletes to have a little bit higher bar and wear that uniform and that responsibility of being a member on the team proudly. We also ask our fans to be very sportsmanlike, and I think we do an excellent job, and I hope you and your families have that same experience when we're able to host in-person games. But Mark, right on that logo is community service as well, and I know in your history at Regis, that's not only been important to you personally with some of the service trips you've taken. Laura Violet as well went on a trip that you can talk about. But talk about the commitment each of our teams has and how that foundation is kind of with the Sisters of St. Joseph.
Yeah, being a Regis College student athlete means more than just competing. Obviously, we're growing physically, competitively. Obviously, we have growth in the classroom that serves on the field or in the pool or on the tennis courts. But we also know the importance of personal growth and transformation. So we, yeah, much driven by the missions, by the mission of the Sisters of St. Joseph, service is a very important component of the student athlete and Regis student experience. So all of our student athletes with their teams have a day of service with their team. Additionally, we find them to be the leaders on Founders Day, leading a group. Yeah. We also have opportunities with the Center for Ministry and Service for weekend service. But the opportunities there are important because service is a lived practice at Regis. One thing that Pam just mentioned, Laura actually took advantage of these as well. I, for one, was on the founding group that took a group of students on spring break to Villa El Salvador, Peru, where we did some work with the people there in a shantytown. There are many groups that still offer trips. We have a group of coaches and students that have traveled to the reservation to work with the Indian population in the Dakotas. And there are new trips actually being sponsored every year, not ever changing. But personally, I think it's one of the best things that we have at Regis. We look for that transformational experience for each one of our student athletes, that they're able to obviously excel in their sport, but also learn in a lot of different ways and really open their soul.
Yeah, that's great. And, you know, part of the, and the students have been on a lot of programming through orientation. And I'm sure one of the themes is an engaged student is typically a happier student that performs better in the classroom, graduates on time. And in addition to your sport, Mark mentioned community service, but Laura Violet, there's other ways for our student athletes to get involved. And honestly, their legacy is a pretty rich tradition in terms of their leadership on campus.
Absolutely. There's so many ways to get involved, and you'll hear this week from some of our student athlete advisory committee members about certainly steps to take to be a campus leader, ways that you can become involved and get outside of your comfort zone and attend some of these service trips that Mark is talking about. And essentially, Pam, you know, what we're saying is athletics is just a piece of your Regis experience. Your athletics is experience is an extension of the classroom. We like to say that your coaches are educators first, and really embrace your other opportunities that you'll have on campus. I think you can do it all. You certainly can do it all. It's just about communicating with those around you, seeking out support when you need it, identifying those areas of support early on campus, and just asking a lot of questions. I think that's really important for new students, first year, first semester students, to be able to just ask questions and feel comfortable not having all the answers. I think that can lead to you stepping outside your comfort zone and then getting involved in other areas of campus. I think that really is the well-rounded Division III experience that we're looking for all of you guys to have.
No question. And our student athletes make up about a third of the undergraduate population, so we're a force to be reckoned with. And we love it when our student athletes are leaders in clubs and activities and student government and orientation leaders and RAs. And we really appreciate that and look forward to seeing some of you in those leadership roles. And we have a little bit of a script that we're following, but I'm going to jump the order. I'm going to bring Ron LeClaire in right now. And Laura had mentioned ask questions. And some of the student athletes may have some questions about training room procedures. And I know later this week, you're going to do a little bit about strength and conditioning. But I'd like to just tap into your overall experience. And you can kind of run with this, whether you want to talk about your staff or some of the things, whether it's rehab or injury prevention. I'm just going to give you a couple minutes to go freelance.
Here we go. So we're lucky to have two former GNAC student athletes on our staff as athletic trainers. So they have a real insight into what it is to be a student athlete, especially at this level and the demand that's placed on you on a daily basis. It's not easy at times. You are going to be challenged. In order to have that transformative experience, you're going to be pushed. You're going to be pushed physically. You're going to be pushed mentally. And with that, I think that comes into tapping into those resources you have available to you. The 2 hours that you spend with me, or the 3 hours you spend doing your sport, is only a minuscule amount of your day on any given day. Those 3 hours, that's great, but you have 21 other hours. How are you handling yourself in those other 21 hours? Are you recovering correctly? Are you sleeping? Are you getting proper nutrition? Are you fueling yourself in order to be successful, to stay healthy, to keep your mind sharp, and to be all the things that you can be on and off the field, in the classroom, and in the community? Those aspects are gigantic, and if you're not taking care of that stuff outside of athletics, you're gonna have a hard time competing in athletics. We have resources available through our partnership with Boston Children's Hospital and our team physicians, as well as with our health center and our counseling services. And of course, being a Catholic university, the spiritual aspect is there on campus as well, and we can tap you into those people. But overall, I haven't ever worked at a more welcoming place with so many people that are here to help you and want to help you to see you succeed. So again, we're excited.
That's great. And Mark, I think, you know, we're going to go off script again. Just from your lens of somebody that's been a lifetime professional and that coachability piece, and do you have any words of wisdom just in terms of, I think Ron mentioned it briefly, but, you know, the patience level, kind of that mentality, I'm a star in high school, you know, I hope I start right away, but what if I don't? Do you have any, just a few words of wisdom around that coachability and expectation piece for our class of 24s on the Zoom?
Yeah, I think one of the most difficult things is that transition that you just mentioned. You know, you're coming from a program where, you know, you were perhaps the star, but you were certainly, your experience led to your status with that group. Now you're in a situation where you're coming into a new group. Well, I guarantee you our coaches are going to make it comfortable for you. We know that. But I think the mentality needs to be that you have a little bit of patience going in, and that you understand that everyone has a role. And roles are really important. I think that's one thing that when you come into, if it's a preseason or the beginning of the year or even off-season workouts, that you keep in mind. It's a process. I think one of the biggest mistakes sometimes athletes make is that they come in and they think they're going to have a much larger role and aren't really too ready to accept what it should be. So communication is important, I think, with the coaching staff. But I think also just let it happen. Grow into your role. I think that would probably be the most important thing there. And we do. And we have roles. And it's not just in on the teams themselves. We have roles for everyone in athletics. That's not just student athletes on varsity teams, because we understand that the athletic program takes a lot of people, and not necessarily just the athletes on the rosters. In addition to the coaches and the staff, we're going to rely on the entire Regis community to make us special, right? So we need the fans packing the den. We need you all to come out and, you know, either supervise the building, the fitness center, other areas within the athletic facility. And then most importantly, I think that we need you as student work studies to come out and work the games for us. If
yes.
You have federal work study, right? Everyone has a role in athletics at Regis. You don't necessarily have to be on the varsity team, because this is your athletic program, it's your school, and we want you to be proud of it.
Right. And unlike high school, Mark isn't referring, we don't have junior varsity teams. He's just saying you can get involved in different ways. We have some 2 and 3 sport athletes with our cross country and track student athletes on the call. But off season, there are a number of opportunities. You could even be the mascot if you wanted to. Reggie or Regina, be a part of our work study crew that we rely on to run. We host about 110, 120 in a regular year. Matches, meets, games. So it's a busy, busy program. Lots of opportunities for that work study and to get involved. And I guess we're wrapping up, but Laura Violet, so studying remotely, put you on the spot. Any tips for Zooming? We still want to have a good relationship with our faculty members. Any tips for our incoming Pride student athletes regarding the remote learning? I know you mentioned that communication piece and kind of working ahead on their schedule, not waiting to the last minute, but I'm gonna give you a few minutes if you have any closing tips for these incoming freshmen.
Yes, it will come as no surprise. I'm gonna stick to the same theme, and that is communication is key. Communication is key for you with your coach. It's key with us as administrators, and it's gonna be key for you to be successful in the classroom. If you ever have a doubt or a question or a concern on any of your academic work or assignments, go to your faculty member. They're there to help you. If you ever have a question for your RA or anyone that works in the residential life staff or student affairs about, you know, your bill or maybe class registration or how to locate someone that you need to seek out on campus, definitely reach out and ask. Communication is going to be very key to your success at Regis.
And you said there are no silly questions. And really, whether it's directing a question to any one of us on this call or your head coach or teammates, and mentors, once you get to school, please don't hesitate to ask. You know, I'm so proud of this group. We're so excited to welcome you. Ron, I'm going to just give you one other chance if you have any closing comments for the group. I know you're going to be on later in the week, so you didn't get as much airtime today because you're going to have your own session with our strength and conditioning coach, Renato Capobianco. But anything for the group as we wrap up?
Yeah, to echo what Mark said, trust the process. A lot of people put undue anxiety and pressure on themselves to be as successful as you might have been at the high school level. Like, that's unfair. It's unfair to you. Don't beat yourself up like that. Trust the process. If you go through the process the right way, you're going to have success, and we're going to have success together. But don't beat yourself up. You got to be able to overcome, be resilient, and manage everything that's going on in our lives, and especially entering a new environment that you're not used to yet. So don't expect it to happen in a day, but trust the process and keep working hard, and we'll do great.
Well, what a great transition, because as you get to know me and hear me speak more, I talk about believing in all the hype about athletics. Ron mentioned resilience. I also talk about the ability to deal with adversity and that stick-to-itiveness and that grit and that tenacity and that competitive spirit and loyalty and teamwork that athletes have. We love athletes. We love working with athletes. We can't wait to work with you. I hope you enjoyed your Meet the Administration session. We are very proud of our program, and we are thrilled to welcome you to the Pride family of athletics. And I think we should go out, gang, with a Go Pride on three. Ready? One, two, three.
Go Pride!
Go Pride!
Hey, class of 2024.
Welcome to Regis.
We can't wait for you to join our pride.
On the court.
In the pool.
Ah! On the field.
Coach Ben, catch this.
And around the track.
Whether it's protecting the ball,
setting up your teammates,
to make the play.
The time is now.
To roar pride.